Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon everyone. We are from Group 5. We will present our material about biological control of plant pathogens. But before we start, let me introduce my group. They are Dila Islami Salsabila, student number 102. Then Putra Setia Dharma, student number 109. Hanifah Salsabila, student number 114. Aditama Satya Graha, student number 124. The first is introduction. Biological control is an effort to control the population of pests and plant disease by using natural enemies such as predators, and pathogens. Biological control is defined as an effort to reduce the density of inoculum or the activity of pathogens in both active and dormant periods by using one or more organisms that are carried out naturally or by manipulation of the environment or host, or through the addition of antagonistic organism. Next.
Okay. Biodiversity is very much determined by the accuracy of the selection of control agent. For that, it is necessary to know about the ecology and biology of the pathogen before determining the control agent to be used. The properties that biological control agent must possess are 1. Able to grow faster than pathogen, 2. Being a competitor against pathogens, and 3. Able to produce antibiosis compound, enzyme, and toxin that can inhibit the growth of the pathogen, 4. Easy to culture on artificial media, and 5. Does not cause disease in plant. Next. Okay, a form of biological control mechanism of plant pathogens. According to Becker, 1990, there are two types of biological control mechanism for plant pathogens. One is exterior to host antagonism, a direct mechanism where biological control again parasitize, suppress, and directly interfere with pathogen with antagonistic property of this microorganism through antibiosis, hyperparasite, and competition. Get to interaction of agent in host. The indirect mechanism is through the interaction of biological control agent on the host plant through colonization and pre-penetration that triggers a self-defense response from the plant. This response is known as the resistant induction mechanism, so that plants can defend themselves from pathogen attacks.
Okay, next is biological control mechanism. Biological control mechanism have four types, namely is colonization, competition, antibiosis, and hyperparasitism. The first is colonization. The colonization on the surface of plant organs occur as a result of dispersal of the inoculum by dispersal agent such as wind, water, animal, and human. The success of the control agent colonization is able to narrow the space for pathogen infection because the control agent has the ability to grow faster to cover plant surfaces of origin. Muslim 2019. The concept of the colonization is more common in disease because by the soil-borne pathogen. Control agents are applied to the plant root system or rhizosphere and in some studies are known to inhibit the growth, development, and infection of soil pathogen or Phytophthora or Pythium. Next. Second is competition. Competition is effort of two or more organisms to obtain food or space under specific condition where is the available in limited quantity. What's up for grab are nutrient or particular carbohydrate as well as nitrogen and some growth factor. Muslim 2019. Biological pathogen, namely place competition, which is related to spread of colonization of countering agent. The phenomenon of this place competition is often found, especially in soil pathogen in the plant root system. For example, mycorrhiza fungi are able to colonization root and even almost cover the root system of plant. This situation makes pathogen fungi do not get a place to contact the root. And competition between microorganisms will cause change in environmental conditions that are less favorable for pathogen, so that pathogen cannot develop perfectly. Next.
Okay, next, antibiosis. Antibiosis in the inhibition of growth and destruction of an organism by antagonistic agents through the production of antibiotic, where the antibiotic is the product of metabolism produced by microbes at low concentration can inhibit the growth and activity of other microorganisms. The product of this metabolism are toxic and are known as antibiotic. These metabolites enter the cell and inhibit their activity with chemical toxic. The breakdown, destruction, decomposition, and decomposition of biological material is also called lysis. There are two types of lysis, namely the first endolysis or autolysis is the destruction of cell cytoplasm by enzyme produced by the cell itself, which cause also cell death, which may be caused by lack of nutrients or by antibiotics or other toxic. The second exolysis or heterolysis is the destruction of cell wall by enzyme or antibiotics produced by other organism. Next. And the last one is hyperparasitism. Microorganism capable of parasitizing other organism are called hyperparasite. Hyperparasitism occurs when antagonistic microbes parasitize pathogenic microbes and take nutrients from these pathogenic microbes by penetrating directly continue to grow and multiply within this microorganism or by coiling around hyphae and penetrating them. Hyperparasites are generally classified as fungi, especially from the Trichoderma verticillium tuberculina maxima group. But there are also nematodes that act as predators that are able to parasitize other nematodes by injecting saliva through their stylet or then removing the contents so that they decompose. Mycoparasites that are very well known and have been used commercially and widely are Trichoderma fungi. Okay, this is the end of our presentation. If you have any question, you can ask in forum or WhatsApp group. Thank you.